Let's follow the teachings of Islam. Let's make an illuminating society. Let's follow the teachings of Islam. Let's make an illuminating society.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, welcome back to our silsila Illuminating the Society. Before I disclose the topic of our today's discussion, let us first make good intentions, as it is mentioned in the beautiful hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, niyatul mu'mini khayrun min amali. The intention of a believer is better than his actions. So let us make good intentions that I will watch this silsila for the pleasure of Allah and His beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And I will watch this silsila from the beginning till the end. And whatever Madani pearls, whatever good Madani points I will learn from this silsila, I will try and note down those Madani pearls. And in a later stage, I will try and read them so that I can recall those beautiful Madani pearls. One more intention we can make in this silsila, and that is that whatever I will learn from this silsila, I will try and act upon it, and I will try and pass its message to others as well, inshallah azza wa jal. Before we commence with our silsila, as it is our routine, that we always commence with our silsila by listening to the ahadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam regarding the virtue of Durud-e Pak. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has beautifully stated that the one who recites 50 times Durud-e Pak upon me daily, I will shake hands with him on the day of Qiyamah. صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم صلاة وسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, the topic which we are going to discuss about today is that cure for anger. Yes, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, in our daily routine lives, many a times it happens that we get angry, and once we get angry, we lose our minds and we don't know what we are saying and what we are doing. So inshallah, we will talk about how to cure our anger and what's the excellence of controlling the anger and regarding the virtues of forgiving others as well. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the tawfiq to speak the truth, and may Allah grant us the tawfiq to make amal upon it. Ameen. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam salatan wa salaman alayka ya sayyidi ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sayyiduna faqih Abu Lays Samarqandi rahmatullah alayhi has narrated in Tanbiyul Ghafilin, Sayyiduna Wahab bin Munabbi rahmatullah alayhi has stated, a pious man from Bani Israel once went somewhere. On the way, suddenly a rock fell from the top and was close to hit his head. He started the zikr of Allah Azza wa Jal and it moved away. Thereafter, terrifying lions and beasts appeared in front of him, but he did not panic and continued with the zikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. When the pious man started his salah, a snake wrapped itself around his foot, crawled over his body and reached his head. When that pious man would intend to perform sajda, the snake would wrap itself around his face. When he would bow his head to prostrate, it would open its mouth as if it would bite him. But the pious man would remove him and would successfully prostrate. When he finished his salah, then shaitan appeared in its true form in front of him and said, "I was the one who did all this to you. You are a very brave person. I am quite impressed by you. Therefore, I have decided that I won't ever incite you through evil whispering and be my friend." Allahu Akbar. The pious man said, "You tried to scare me, but Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, I didn't get scared and I will never be your friend." Shaitan said, "Okay, at least ask me the condition of your family members. What will they go through after your demise?" The pious man replied, "I do not need to ask you." Shaitan then said, "At least ask me how I trick and deceive people." The pious man said, "Yes, tell me this thing." Shaitan said, "I have 3 traps. Number 1, stinginess. Number 2, anger. Number 3, intoxication." Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, Shaitan is telling this pious man how he deceives people, how he tricks people towards guna, how he calls people towards committing sins. And he gave him that, "I have 3 steps. And from those 3 steps, one of the steps which Shaitan uses for a person to commit guna is that he said, I make people angry. And once a person gets angry, that's the way I lead people towards committing guna." And he himself explains this thing. He says, "When I manage to make someone fall into the trap of anger, I play with him and toss him around the group of shaitans, as children play with a ball. Regardless of the high status attained in knowledge and deeds by an angry person, even if he can resurrect the deeds by his du'as, I am still not disappointed with him. I always have hope that he will lose his temper, and at some time or other, in burst of anger, he will utter such a thing which will destroy his hereafter." Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, we have just heard how Shaitan plays with the person who gets angry. He gives an example that a child plays with a ball. That's how I play with that person. And it becomes very easy for him. He molds that person towards committing guna. Shaitan says that, "I don't get scared even if he makes dua and he recovers all his good deeds, because Shaitan always has hope that if not now, then in any other time, the person will get angry and will utter something which will destroy his akhirat, which will destroy his hereafter." Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, undoubtedly, with uttering such kind of words, a person can destroy his dunya as well as his hereafter. It is very necessary and important for us to cure our anger and to rectify ourselves from this disease. Sayyiduna Imam Muhammad Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi has stated in his book Kimya-i Sa'adat, "Curing anger and suffering hardships and showing forbearance while treating it is fard, because the majority of people will enter hell due to their anger." Allahu Akbar. In another place, Sayyiduna Hassan Basri rahmatullah alayhi has stated, "O man, in the state of anger, you jump up and down too much, lest the next jump should plug you into hell." Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, undoubtedly, anger can lead us towards Jahannam. Anger can lead us towards committing guna. Because once a person gets angry, he does not know what he is uttering. He does not know what he is doing, because he goes out of control, and many a times a person loses his sense. Yes, dear viewers of Madani Channel, anger is a very bad thing, and it makes it easier for shaitan to lead us towards committing guna. Anger is such a bad habit that from this bad habit, we go towards many guna. We commit lot of sins just because of this one bad habit of ours, and that is anger. For example, when a person gets angry, he gets jealousy. Number two, backbiting, tale-bearing, malice, breaking ties, lying, dishonoring others, considering others to be inferior to oneself, swearing, arrogance, quarreling, mocking others, breaking of ties with relatives. Allahu Akbar, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel. Many a times we have seen that people break even family ties just because they got angry on small things. They make one small issue as a major issue. When there is time to talk and reconcile with family members, but if a person is angry in that, he doesn't want to listen to what the second person is saying. He just wants to break off ties. And remember, there is great, great thawab in combining with one's relatives. And there is big guna, lot of sins, just to break ties with our family members. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the tawfiq to cure this disease of us. And may we forgive others on their mistakes. Ameen. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Salatun wa salamun alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, as we have heard that this anger leads us towards committing lot of sins, towards lot of guna. So how to cure this disease of ours? One of the way to cure ourselves from this disease is that we should listen to the excellence regarding controlling the anger. We should listen to the excellence and virtues of forgiving others. Let us listen to few beautiful ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam regarding controlling the anger. It is stated in Sahih Bukhari, a man approached in the court of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and said, O beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, please advise me. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, do not get angry. The person said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, give me more advice. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam gave him the same reply, that do not get angry. And Sayyiduna Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu has stated that I humbly asked the beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam to tell me such an act which will lead me towards paradise. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam replied, La taghdab walakal jannah. That is, do not get angry, then jannat is for you. Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he himself is giving us the glad tidings of paradise. He is giving this basharat to those people who get angry and control their anger. He is giving basharat to those people who control their anger. In today's time and era, we regard the strongest person as the one who does go to gym. The strongest person is the one who can carry the most weight. We regard that person to be the strongest person amongst us. But this very same question came in the court of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. And listen to what our beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam said regarding the strongest person. It is stated in Sahih Bukhari, the powerful man is not one who is wrestler, overpowers the people, but the powerful man is the one who controls himself in the state of anger. Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah. It is stated in Kanzul Umal that the beloved and blessed Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam has stated, whoever has the ability and power to express his anger, but he controls it, on the day of Qiyamah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will fill his heart with his pleasure. Subhanallah. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, what a good basharat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam is giving us for controlling anger. And he has also mentioned that the strongest person is the one who controls his anger in the state of angerness. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the tawfiq to control our anger. And may Allah grant us the tawfiq to forgive others as well. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, I would like to narrate few incidents which took place with Sahaba Ikram. When people saw them, when people got angry on them, did they retaliate with them or not? Let us listen to those beautiful sayings of Sahaba Ikram and lifestyles of Sahaba Ikram. A person saw at Amirul Mu'mineen Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He replied, I have other faults too, like this, which Allah Azza wa Jal has kept concealed from you. Allahu Akbar. When a person saw it, Amirul Mu'mineen, Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, I have many faults like this, but Allah Azza wa Jal has concealed them from you. Allahu Akbar. He did not get angry on him. He did not fight back with him, but rather he told him in a very beautiful way. Allahu Akbar. A person saw at Sayyiduna Shaabi Rahmatullah Ali. He Rahmatullah Ali replied, if you have spoken the truth, may Allah Azza wa Jal forgive me. And if you have lied, may Allah Azza wa Jal forgive you. Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, what a beautiful mindset our pious predecessors had. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, we should try and always control our anger. We should listen to regarding the excellence of controlling anger, regarding the virtues of forgiving others. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, undoubtedly, due to angerness, many people have lost their faith. Yes, they have lost their iman by uttering kufr, and they didn't even realize. As I have mentioned earlier, that when a person is angry, he does not know what he is uttering. He loses his sense. And many people, many people have stated kufr in the state of angerness. And they don't even realize. And even if they do realize, they give lame excuses that we were not incensed, we were angry. Allahu Akbar, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel. Once the kufr is uttered, our nikah nullifies, our nikah breaks, our bay'at breaks. We need to renew our tajdeed-e-iman. We need to read our kalima once again. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, let us not destroy our akhirat. Let us try to mold ourselves towards those people who rectify us, those people who want us to take us towards paradise. And today's era, alhamdulillah, we have such an organization which is motivating us towards paradise, which is motivating us towards performing good deeds. Let us join that beautiful mahal, that beautiful environment of Dawat Islami, so that we can rectify ourselves and we can rectify the people of the entire world. This is the madani maqsad of Dawat Islami, that I must try to reform myself and the people of the entire world. Inshallah Azza wa Jal. This is the beautiful madani maqsad given to us by our Pir Murshid, Amir al-Sunnat, Hazrat Allama Mawlana, Muhammad Ilyas Attar Qadri, Tahmat Barakatum Al-Aliya. And alhamdulillah, upon acting this beautiful mission, Dawat Islami has reached more than 200 countries to rectify the people of this universe. It's a humble request to one and all out there to please join this beautiful mahal, to please attend the weekly ijtima taking place in your areas, and if possible, try and travel with the devotees of Ashikani Rasul in Madani Qafilas. Yes, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, if you have children, enroll your children towards Madrasatul Madina. And if you are adult watching out there, then there is an opportunity for you as well. Dawat Islami has opened Madrasatul Madina Balighan. Yes, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, adult people come for these classes. And in these classes, only adult people are learning Quran according to Tajweed. And many ahkam of Shariat, many laws of Islamic jurisprudence are taught in these beautiful classes of Dawat Islami. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the tawfiq to join this beautiful mahal of Dawat Islami. Allah karam, aisa kare tujh pe jahan mein, ae Dawat Islami. تیری دھوم مچی ہو صلو علی الحبیب صلی اللہ تعالی علی محمد صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم صلاة و سلام علیک یا سیدی یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم Yes, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, as I mentioned earlier, that there are many virtues and excellence of controlling one's anger and forgiving others. Yes, there are many people who have been forgiven by Allah Azza wa Jal just by us forgiving others. Yes, if we forgive others, then inshallah Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive us. We should have hope in the beautiful mercy of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. The beloved Rasul Sallallahu Ta'ala Alayhi wa Sallam once summoned a servant to do some work, but he arrived late. The beloved and blessed Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam had a miswak in his hand. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if the revenge had not been destined to be on the day of Qiyamah, I would have used this miswak to beat you. Allahu Akbar. Huzur alayhi salatu wa sallam never got angry on any other person because of himself. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, we should also practice upon it. We should not get angry on others because of our personal reasons. Many of us take revenge because of our personal grudges. We should learn from this beautiful ahadith and lifestyles of our beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. It is stated in Sahih Muslim, Sayyidina Abu Mas'ud Ansari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, I was disciplining my servant. Then I heard a voice behind me, O Abu Mas'ud, you should be aware that Allah Azza wa Jal has more power over you than you have over him. Hazrat Sayyidina Abu Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, I turned around and it was the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. I humbly stated, O Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, huwa hurrun li wajhillah. He is freed for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. The beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, if you had not done so, you would have been burnt in the hellfire. Or he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the fire of hell would have touched you. Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, this is the beautiful teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. This is the practical life of Sahaba-i-Kiram and Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. That they would forgive others and they would encourage and motivate others to forgive one another. We should also forgive our relatives who have hurt us. We should forgive our friends who have hurt our feelings. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, undoubtedly, with the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, if we forgive someone, Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive us on the day of Qiyamah. It is said that the wife of a person once added a lot of salt in the food. He got very furious but managed to control his anger, thinking, I also make many mistakes. If I treated her harshly today due to her mistakes, Allah Azza wa Jal might also punish me for my sins on the day of Qiyamah. Therefore, he overlooked this mistake without telling his wife anything. After his demise, someone saw him in the dream and asked him, مَا فَعَلَ اللَّهُ بِكَ? How has Allah Azza wa Jal treated you? He replied, Torments were about to be inflicted upon me due to the abundance of my sins. When Allah Azza wa Jal said, My bondwoman had added too much salt in the food and you had forgiven her mistakes, I also forgive you today in return of that act of kindness. Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, we have just heard how Allah Azza wa Jal forgave a person because he forgave his wife for adding salt in the food. So small thing. Allah Azza wa Jal liked it. And Allah Azza wa Jal forgave that person. As you are saying, the torments were about to be inflicted upon him. But Allah Azza wa Jal showered his mercy because he forgave the bandi, the woman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should also show kindness towards people. And dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, we should try and control our tongue. Tongue is something which causes a lot of fights. Because once you utter something, many a times it happens that we break the hearts and feelings of other peoples. We exaggerate regarding the rights of other Muslim brothers and sisters in our community. Huzur Ali Salatu Wassalam has said, The one who remains silence won deliverance. In another hadith he says that silence is the worship of high virtue. Allahu Akbar. There are many excellence of using our tongue properly. And the one who cannot speak beneficially, he should remain silent. Because it is better for him to remain silent. Because if he will say something, there is a possibility that fights may occur. There is a possibility that when these fights will occur, people might even kill each other. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us the tawfiq to act upon whatever we have heard. And may Allah grant us the tawfiq to cure our anger. And may Allah grant us the tawfiq to forgive others as well. Ameen. Bijahin Nabil Ameen. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib. Sallallahu ta'ala على محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم.
Let's follow the teachings of Islam. Let's make an illuminating society. Let's follow the teachings of Islam. Let's make an illuminating society.